Hello and welcome to Newsmax TV. I'm John Bachman. Right now we have Congressman Mike Kelly joining us on the phone from Western Pennsylvania. He's also a member of the House Oversight Committee. Congressman, thanks for spending some time with us.
Oh, John, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
No problem. We want to get a quick reaction from you on the unemployment numbers just announced this Friday morning. They're now down below 8% for the first time since 2009. Do you think these numbers will have any impact on this presidential race?
You know what? I would doubt that. Where I'm from, there's a lot of people who've given up looking for work altogether, and I think a lot of people look at the unemployment rates. You know what? That doesn't make sense. I haven't had to work for a long time, but the job futures don't look good to me, and a lot of people are wondering how they come up with these figures. And I said, well, you know what? You got to understand that people who no longer are looking for work no longer are there, and the true unemployment rate is probably been about somewhere around 11 or 12%. So while it may have one campaign an opportunity. I think things are getting better. The people out in the real world, outside the Beltway, who are actually on the ground and trying to make a living and trying to get a job, are still in that same situation. In the automobile business, which I'm in, when we talk to people on the lot and in the showrooms, it's the uncertainty of their future and the uncertainty of their job and the availability of their job, or if they'll even be making the same amount of money, that really keeps them from making that decision to make the purchase.
And we know that the Obama campaign, the Obama administration, are really going to hype up these numbers moving forward out here on the campaign trail. If you're the Romney campaign, how do you counter the Democrats and the Obama campaigns, trying to exploit these numbers?
Well, you know what? I think the American people are starting to understand that the emperor truly has no clothes. They've been gamed now for the last 3.5, almost 4 years, and they're looking at things more realistically. You know, a campaign has a certain mission that it's on, and that's always to take whatever it has to work with and try to spin it to make it look like something good is happening. I would just say that in the real world, the world that I come from and the world that I live in, it's a lot more apparent to people that the future right now is too uncertain. The job creators that I talk to every day, because of tax policy and regulation policy and everything else, doesn't give them the certainty that they want to move ahead with the decision that looks like it's got more of a chance to succeed than it does to fail. And it's the uncertainty of, again, John, honestly, it's not hard for anybody. Really, this is not a Republican or Democrat thing. This is just a real common sense, regular American thing that people discuss at their kitchen table about, okay, what is it that we can look forward to? And if we're not sure, we're going to hold off. So I'm a little bit dubious of all the different spins that are put on it and put back and forth. I think we just keep going ahead with a country that has been so blessed by our Creator with natural resources that really make us the envy of the world. Why aren't we going after those? Why has it taken this president 4 years to move ahead with a plan that he can articulate with not just the flowery talk and the rhetoric, but actually something that would be something that people could actually say, okay, fine, I understand it. I can see how it's going to happen. I know how it's going to work. So there's a lot out there I guess campaigns would work on, but real Americans, people who struggle every day, and they, especially our middle-income and lower-income families, are really, really being crushed by an Obama economy that just has not allowed them to look at the future with any confidence.
I also want to transition, if you don't mind, and talk about your role as a member of the House Oversight Committee. I know the chairman, sure, Daryl Issa, recently sent a letter to the State Department seeking some answers on the September 11th attacks, the terrorist attacks in Libya and as well in Egypt. We know two arrests now have been made, but ABC News, Jake Tapper, is reporting that there are new reports that the State Department denied a request for, this was back in May, for a security detail. From everything that you've seen here, do you think that there was some negligence maybe involved that may have prevented these attacks from happening had the State Department, the Obama administration, maybe paid attention to these threats?
Well, yeah, I know you and I both know. The State Department solely is responsible for the security of our consuls and embassies around the world and our personnel. I would say that this, again, is another an indication of a dereliction of duty of an administration, really, including the Secretary of State. She doesn't walk away from this one. Now, she's been kind of, to me, it's been obvious that she has been absent from the podium when it comes to addressing us, other than making the first claim that it was all because of a 15-minute YouTube piece that incited these people. Now, it's taken this long for them to come out and say, well, this is what we think happened after the rest of the world already knew it. The State Department and the executive branch are to be held responsible for this. They are solely responsible for the safety and security of our our embassies and our consuls and of our personnel overseas. There is a dereliction of duty, which is very consistent with this administration. And then they come back later and say, well, you know what, we weren't made aware, we weren't sure, we didn't have the right indications, we're holding off until we get the right information. This one doesn't pass the smell test, and it is very consistent with an administration and an executive, chief executive officer, that's more interested in running for office than running the country.
And do you see the Oversight Committee holding some hearings, or do you think this is a situation where the public needs to hear from some officials in the State Department?
I definitely do, and, you know, the Oversight Committee, I really do think it is an honor and a privilege to serve on that with Chairman Issa. The American people have the right to know, and we have the responsibility to find out for them. And when you can't get the answers, and when they're not forthcoming and they're not forthright from the administration, and the administration has said, by the way, this will be the most clear and transparent administration we've ever seen. Nothing to be true or false. This is the murkiest group I've ever worked with. It's hard to get an answer. You ask for information, it's all redacted. It comes in late. We have briefings that are supposed to be highly confidential. And really, the briefing I sat in with the Secretary of State and some of our other military people was truly a briefing in that it was so brief. I got up at about 5 minutes left because nothing's going to be said here. The American people are not going to know until after the election what really happened. And I think that for those Americans that are paying attention, again, they're seeing a consistency in an administration that refuses to come forth and say, you know what, we weren't paying attention.
All right, Congressman, I know you have a busy day ahead of you out there on the campaign trail in western Pennsylvania. I want to thank you very much for spending some time with us today. It was great talking with you.
John, thanks so much. Anytime you need me, I'm available. But thank you so much.